Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to induct into the Hall of Fame and to introduce you to the toughest SOB in the history of the WWE, Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Hi, guys. Thank you very much for that. Thank you very much. I want to say something real quick about this suit. Everybody here in the WWE that knows me knows that I don't like to get dressed up very many times in a year. And I had this tuxedo made in Los Angeles, California, at the men's warehouse, and that guy always says, you're gonna like the way you look, I guarantee it. Well, I like the way I look, I'm happy with all that, but the damn button popped off right in the back, and I'm going into the Hall of Fame. I got 15,000 people, I got a couple of million around the globe watching this, and I got a button popping off my jacket because of the men's warehouse. You know, it's very easy for me to go out into an arena and cut a promo and try to sell tickets. It's what I love to do, and there's a feeling that I get from that. It's hard for me to explain really to anybody how I feel about the business because it's affected me in such a way and been such a big part of my life. But I watched that video probably 50 times in a row to try to come up with words to say to you people, words that would live up to my expectations or my standards and your expectations. And if I don't succeed at that, I want you to come away from the night knowing from Stone Cold Steve Austin, I want to tell each and every person here and each and every person that ever watched Stone Cold Steve Austin or the World Wrestling Entertainment, thank you so much. I want to thank you so much for always sticking with me. As hot as I got and as high as I got in this company and set records and took the business to the level that I took it to, the times when I would go down with a neck injury and I'd get a surgery on my neck, or I'd blow a knee out, or I'd get a divorce, or I'd blow my other knee out, or I'd get my neck worked on again and get another divorce. And then there's the one time I took my ball and went home, as the WWE was so fond of saying. And I was gone for a year. And every time I came back from something like that, you people always took me back, and I've always appreciated that. It has been my pleasure and a privilege to make my living in a squared circle, 20 feet by 20 feet. There's not too many things, you know, in this life that I'm good at. And it's just, I don't know about that. There's not too many things I'm good at. You know, I've got a bunch of friends that ended up being football coaches. My friends down there in South Texas are all into construction and contractors. And my dad was an insurance man and my mom an interior decorator. And I always wondered what I would be, you know, as a big fan of professional wrestling, still trying to put all the information together in my head. And I remember when I was in high school in Edna, Texas, 100 miles south down US 59. I took my little high school aptitude test and I circled in all the little dots and all the stuff that you did, and a couple weeks later the information came back and to try to guide you into a career of what you should do with your life. And when I got my little test back, it said that I would make a real swell park ranger. Park ranger's cool, I got nothing against a good old park ranger, but it just wasn't gonna work for Stone Cold Steve Austin. So I've had a blast riding up and down the road and in this wonderful business that I've been, met some of the greatest people that I've ever met in this business. And by the same token, I've met some bad ones too. And I've got no complaints. I've got nothing to gripe or complain about. I've gotten beat up. I've gotten my share of stitches and staples and broken bones and surgeries just like the rest of these men and women have. And man, I got a big smile on my face, and I'm here to say thank you for all of it. I want to close the door on my wrestling career, but I don't want to close the door on you. I want to say thank you. And as I move away from professional wrestling and I move into the movie industry or that line of work, I just want you to be able to continue to support me and know that I'll do whatever I can to try to entertain you the best I can. It's been a wonderful pleasure. And I could sit up here and talk for another damn hour, and I haven't even used none of my notes. WrestleMania is tomorrow. If you're ready for WrestleMania, give me a hell yeah. Well, let's wrap this thing up. I'd like for the young men, the superstars and the divas, to get a good nice rest or get a good start on a cold drink before they go to work tomorrow night. It's going to be a good night here in Houston, Texas. I thank you again. I love you from the bottom of my heart. And that's the bottom line, because Stone Cold said so.